Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Ranger's Respite. I am Philip. I am here with Christina, the actual creator of the proprietor of the Ranger's Respite.
Me!
Yeah. So actually, that might be kind of a fun story, explaining why my home bar is called the Ranger's Respite, if the proprietor of the Ranger's Respite is a character that you played. Because that's kind of a weird story. So, it starts with, I'm a weirdo, and so, like, when I'm doing, like, world building, I tend to use characters that I've played and that my friends have played as NPCs, sort of, just for fun. And, like, for example, in the campaign where Christina played Ezra, whose last name I can't remember.
God, I still have her character sheet somewhere.
I played Ballas Beardstone, who was a particularly tall dwarf fighter and retired pit boxer. And Nick played a barbarian who's... Was his name Balthazar?
Balthus or something.
Yeah, something like that. Who was the most verbose barbarian in the world.
God, that was ridiculous.
Which reminds me, did you know there's apparently some kids in that world who are convinced that the state bird of Ohio is a femur?
That's fucking great.
They don't know what Ohio is. Or a femur. Yet. But they know yet. That the state bird of Ohio is the femur.
Yep.
But anyway, so Ballas runs a bar that is you know, one of those like craft breweries that has a tap room and a fighting pit, because in D&D world you can do that.
That's legal.
Yeah.
Man, that'd be fun.
Various other characters have various businesses, and because I'm a huge Critical Role fan, there's in the city where the Ranger's Respite is, there's also the Bailey Bank and Loan and a Willingham Strong Jaw Gym, and Jim is spelled wrong. It's JYM. And, you know, assortment of other things. Well, I have a tendency to then go back through and flesh things out. And because the way I laid out the city, the farthest east on the map, the farthest east building was the Ranger's Respite. So I started on that. And then I lost the map. So basically the only thing I had fleshed out was the Ranger's Respite, which is run by Ezra. And it's a fun place. Ezra's number two in charge is a big, balding ex-adventurer who was a ranger when he was 40 pounds lighter and 30 years younger. And also, he used to have beautiful, flowing gold hair, but can't tell now. Mm-hmm. His name is Fry Cook, F-R-Y-E. C-O-O-K-E. But, I needed a name for my home bar, so I decided to call it the Ranger's Respite, because it is, unironically, the best bar name I have ever come up with.
It's really good.
And at some point, I'm going to get a portrait of Ezra done, and a portrait of Fry Cook, and I'm going to put them on the wall. Probably between the sword hilts. And I will move the Employee of the Month placard back and forth between the two. But, so yeah, that's why my bar is the Ranger's Respite. Oh, the other thing that's fun about the Ranger's Respite is there's the front room where anyone can sit, and then the back room, where the Forest Wardens can go. And the Forest Wardens is basically anybody who is a ranger who looks after the woods. And they buy, sell, trade, etc. and so forth. And there are or a series of dartboards with crude drawings of a face that looks kind of like Ezra's, but not quite. The features are a little bit broader and less feminine. And if you ask Ezra who it is, she just grunts at you. I've got a little bit more time, so I think I will... I actually don't remember what the story I was going to tell you was. Oh, geez. What was it? Was it Highway to the Danger Zone?
I think so.
So the first time I did Tomb of Annihilation, I did it with Frosty, Christine, Rachel. Rachel from PetSmart, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
And Brian, I think. Oh, I shouldn't say his last name. I'll bleep that out. or cover it up with a cork pop. Brian, you know, the group that I used to play D&D with a lot. And I was playing Viggo Tillium, a tiefling bard who on Chult, the tropical hot as fuck island, was rolling around in a full hooded cloak, either a comedy or tragedy mask. Or actually, he traded the comedy mask for a bird mask. And with his legs and arms, wrapped so that you couldn't tell that his skin was slightly purpley, or that he was a tiefling, because where he was from, tieflings are not popular.
Not kosher.
Yep. So out in the jungle, we get to the top of Kir Sabal. After losing our half-giant down the side of the Firefinger, which was unfortunate.
Mm.
We made it to the top of Kir Sabal and were granted the ability to fly through a sort of ritual that allowed us that. But anyway, so Viggo, of course, being a bard, has to do everything in a fantastical way. So all others are like deciding how they're going to take off, Viggo runs full tilt off the edge and flies. And because I'm a jerk, I'm like, hey, Frosty, can I like buzz the tower? And he, of course, picked up on it immediately. He said, that's a negative ghost rider. The pattern is full. So I said, yeah, I'm buzzing it. So I start playing Highway to the Danger Zone on my lute, and I fly as fast as I can right over the top of Kir Sabal. And he's like, okay. Everybody else standing on the top of Kir Sabal, you start hearing Viggo playing his lute, and as he flies past you, the ripple of his cloak sounds a little bit like a fighter jet flying by. So I got to play Highway to the Danger Zone and do a flyby on the tower while sounding kind of a little bit like a jet to people who had never heard one before, because fighter jets don't exist in D&D. That would be kind of a fun homebrew, though. Absolutely stupid, but a ton of fun.
Mm-hmm. That sounds fantastic.
And let's see, that was shortly before our Yonti Pureblood fucking betrayed us. I mean, she wasn't a party member, she was our guide. She betrayed us. And Viggo wants to kill her now because he saw the scales on her that she was trying to hide. And it's like, mm-hmm. Oh, you're like me, an outcast, because of the way you look. And then she turned around and stabbed him in the back.
Ugh, unfortunate.
And spoiler alert for Tomb of Annihilation, real quick. With my second party doing Tomb of Annihilation, we have gotten as far as Omu. We just finished the second temple. and my character only took 30 something points of fucking radiant damage. The good news is he is a beef tank and still had like 20 hit points left.
Good for him.
That's Gail McCann, the Gullo Glass Man.
I remember.
Someday I'm going to have to actually pony up cash and get all my characters drawn.
I've been working on learning how to draw tieflings properly. That's taking me so long.
Oh, I should someday tell people the story of Timothy Timbits Ballantyne, but I think I'm going to tell that story when I tell the story of the bag of soup.
Unfortunate.
It's one of my new favorite magic items.
Of course it is.
It can
be texted to Sierra yet.
I sent it to her over Discord. She hasn't replied yet. I told Frosty that I sent it to Sierra and then said she hasn't responded yet. And he said, "How do you respond to that?"
Violently.
Oh man. By the way, if you would like to read the description of the magical bag of soup, it is contained on my Tumblr blog, Mediocre Magic Items, which I was hesitant to actually give out because, like, it's the one place where very few of my friends know about my social media presence there. But you know what? Fuck it. If you want to read about mediocre magic items and occasionally terrible NPCs like Ollytook, find me there. I might drop a link in the description. I might not. There will definitely be links to other things. All the usual stuff. I added a coffee. I don't know how it's actually supposed to be pronounced.
Coffee.
Yeah. Okay. Coffee. I added a coffee.
Coffee. But like the fish.
Yeah.
Like the fish coffee.
I even added a banner picture thing that's the same as my Patreon one. Currently don't support me on Patreon because I can't get into my Patreon account.
Oh no, they're helpful like that.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on. But yeah, I've been posting stuff there. Usually links, but also like the rain cloak description and Ollytook's disguising mustache. And someday I'm going to write a whole book that is just an inventory of Ollytook's terrible magic items. It's going to be fantastic.